Well, the deadlock between the pro and anti-Gaddafi forces rolls on violently in Libya. And in Syria, over the weekend, the bully boy tactics of the regime there reached new lows with more than 130 pro-democracy civilians summarily killed. As tanks and troops stormed the country's third biggest city, the US ambassador in Damascus warned that the Assad government has declared, quote-unquote, full-on warfare against its own people.
As tanks rolled into the city, army snipers took to the rooftops. Families out to collect their morning bread were shot dead. The siege of Hama was over. The time had come for a concerted effort by President Assad's forces to crush the uprising on the eve of Ramadan. Some 95 people are reported to have been killed in this one city alone.
Snipers stationed on top of public buildings, on schools, on top of hospitals and other places, and started to shoot at people in the streets.
Tank shells were falling at the rate of 4 a minute. Blood transfusions were in short supply. Nobody's counted the number of injured. But not every soldier and every tank was prepared to take part. Some crossed over to the side of the protesters.
Some soldiers deserted their tanks and fled with the residents. About 57 soldiers fled and split away from the army.
The US has described the attack on Hama as desperate, but this appears to be part of a coordinated strategy by the Syrian president and his military. His forces put down a demonstration in Damascus today using nail bombs. Tanks were also transported to other parts of the country to be used in attacks on 4 other towns. Scores of people were rounded up. But all this has only served to instill greater resistance. Demonstrators came out in defiance to protest against the assault on Hama with the fear of history repeating itself. The city witnessed the massacre of 30,000 people back in 1982 when the current president's father ordered troops to slaughter as many as needed to halt an uprising then.
What a mess. Well, how long is it now? 6 months or more of no let up in Libya and Syria, no democracy? Whatever happened to that so-called Arab Spring?